Everybody, thank you for coming. I'd like to introduce my longtime friend and colleague and fellow catalyst staff member, Kristina Hoeppner. We go back way, way, well, a really, really long time before you even joined Catalyst, and pretty much part of the reason I'm at Catalyst is because of Kristina. Yeah, I'm very, very honoured to introduce her, and I'm really looking forward to seeing this. So I'm going to press record now, and over to you.
Thank you very much, Sam, for this introduction. And I'm really, really happy to be here today as well at the Catalyst EUser Community Conference. It's fantastic to see a number of familiar names and also a number of new names. As Sam said, I'm Kristina Hoeppner, and I'm the Mahara project lead for the entire Mahara project and work at Catalyst IT in Te Whanganui Atara, Wellington, Aotearoa, New Zealand. So since we are going into our summer season down here, being 6 months, having 6 month difference to the Northern Hemisphere, I thought I'll actually also show you a little bit of what Aotearoa looks like right now, in particular in the region where I live, which is Wellington and Kapiti Coast, so just a bit up north on the western side of New Zealand. And all the slides feature the pohutukawa, which is also dubbed the New Zealand Christmas tree. So you'll see lovely dark red trees throughout today's presentation. So just so that you know why I've chosen this theme. And what I want to talk about today, so in the next roughly half hour, but hopefully we'll also have some time for a few questions, is what is actually next on the Mahara roadmap. Of course, before we can go into the future, it is also always good to look back. And so I'd like to look back a little bit over this year that is going to be over very shortly, and just mention a few of the highlights that we've seen this year in the two releases that we have. We always have a release in April, so this year the number then would be Mahara 22.04. And we have a release in October, which is 22.10, because we use the dates, so the year and then the month in which the version of Mahara was released, as indicators for version numbers to make it easier to know how old or how young your Mahara version is, because every version is supported for 18 months. And so in Mahara 2204, we had a number of bigger and also smaller features, amongst them better templating support so that you could automate a number of things. You could download smart evidence frameworks if you worked with that. It was also easier to install and update language packs to get updated translations in right through the administration interface without needing to bug any system administrators and install them on the server. We've also made a major upgrade to our full text search. Some of you might be using Elasticsearch. The easiest way to know if you are or if you aren't is to log into your Mahara site. And if your search bar just says search and doesn't say search for people, then you are using full text search and therefore can also have access to advanced reports. So we've upgraded to the then latest version of Elasticsearch, which was a major technical undertaking, and in order to be up to date there. We also made some more technical changes in the area of web services so that you can now actually upload files via web services. So for example, if your student management system were to gather diploma files and you want to push them directly into the portfolio of students, that would be a possibility. And last, but definitely not least, we've created functionality to allow the submission of portfolios into Moodle, which is not a new thing because we've been able to do that already. However, now you can do that via our original. So that requires an update to that plugin, And if you want to know all about that plugin, which hasn't yet been publicly released, but as far as I know, is on the verge to being released, then please have a chat with one of your Catalyst EU account managers, because they would know where the code is at and when it is available for general consumption. So those were just a few of the highlights for Mahara 22.04. Quite a few on the technical side, because we do want to also make technical updates besides just new functionality. And now to Mahara 22.10. That release, in terms of new functionality, was smaller than previous releases, because again, we needed to focus quite a bit on the technical side of things. Richard had already mentioned in his introduction that with Moodle 4, there's also PHP version upgrades that are coming. And of course, that is also coming for Mahara, because Mahara also uses PHP as programming language. And so a lot of our work went into making Mahara compatible with PHP 8.1. And we definitely invite people to put that onto a testing environment and give that a thorough test, because right now it's an experimental support. And we wouldn't quite encourage people yet to put that into production. But of course, the more people are testing, the better we know also when we can take it out of the experimental lab. But in terms of new features or usability changes, we've made changes to the image upload, so that you can now distinguish between alt text and image captions and have both displayed and used. There are more quick edit blocks available, so that you don't have to go into full edit mode in order to change content of blocks, but can now do that not only on text blocks, but also on PDFs and file uploads and also course information. There's also a new report for smart evidence, so that you have an overview of all the smart evidence collections and how many of the assessment options have already been achieved. And if you are using Mahara and have multiple institutions on your site, then you can move accounts via CSV file between the institutions, which is in particularly handy if you don't use single sign-on, where you might have all of that information available. A couple more technical updates. One that is actually also quite visual is that we now support Font Awesome 6. So you will see new icons there, slightly different look, but still the same meaning. And we've also upgraded to Bootstrap 5. So quite a lot on the technical side. And so that kind of takes me to let you know what sort of things are generally on the roadmap for Mahara. Well, we do want to make usability improvements in every version of Mahara, because we see that workflows have changed or that they can be optimized. And one of those changes now in 22.10 was the quick edit option, so that it's much faster to work in template portfolios without having to worry about accidentally moving blocks around or accidentally deleting blocks. So in every version of Mahara, we want to make usability improvements. Sometimes they are smaller, sometimes they are bigger. Usability improvements often do flow also into feature development, or feature development also has an impact on usability improvements. So they are often very closely related, but I did want to distinguish between them, because new features, those are often the ones where you see new features available for the creation of portfolios, or in the case of 22.10, where we created a new report for a feature, or where we create a new block type or new way of interacting with the platform. And we'll come to a few of those exciting things in 23.04 shortly. I've already mentioned that there are also technical updates necessary, and they are an integral part of our roadmap, because our roadmap shouldn't just focus on usability and feature development, usability improvements and features, but to also make sure that the underlying architecture and infrastructure of Mahara is updated and kept up to date with where the programming languages go and also what libraries we use, so that we can make sure that we still have a modern code base. And of course, also part of our daily work is the bug fixing, the issue resolution, to make sure that things get fixed. If either a new bug was introduced or a long-standing one can finally be worked on. Last but not least, part of the work that the team at Catalyst in Wellington is doing for the community is also taking care of the community infrastructure. Because like your Mahara sites, like your Moodle sites, all our sites, all our demo sites, the community wiki, the manual, and our code review system, our testing platform, all of these needs to be kept up to date. And so that, of course, also falls to our team to make sure that operating systems are updated, that new versions are applied as well. And so that, of course, needs to be part of our roadmap for what we can work on within a 6-monthly timeframe. So in every version of Mahara, you find all of these components. Of course, in Mahara itself, we only talk about the first four. So the UX, feature, tech updates, and issue resolution, because the community infrastructure is not really something that goes into Mahara itself. Now, speaking of roadmap, of course, the question is, what is coming up in Mahara 23.04? If you haven't yet looked at the shared notes, you will definitely find the links to the two big features that I briefly want to introduce to you in the shared notes, so that you can explore them on your own. Because there's a lot of writing, there's a lot of mockups as well, and I'd definitely be interested in hearing your feedback. And later in the month, I will also make a video about this first feature, namely the outcomes portfolio. So the outcomes portfolio is a massive new feature in Mahara that we are initially implementing on the group level. It is work we are doing for one of our clients in the UK, which will allow us to set up outcomes within a collection, track those outcomes, but also set check-in points for each individual Mahara page, and collaborate, because we are using the group, collaborate on those portfolios, but with different roles. So that, for example, group administrators can edit the outcomes and add new outcomes, but regular group members who are to fill in these portfolios are not able to set up new pages and change anything on the infrastructure of the portfolio, but can still contribute to the content. And one of the UX features that we are putting into this outcome portfolio is that you can create a page, in this case called an activity, directly from within a collection. So that avoids having to go out of the collection, creating clicking the create button, selecting a page, creating the page, and then putting it into the collection. So you're probably saving at least 30 seconds to a minute by having this new button there. And so we are trialing that on that portfolio. So if you go to the shared notes, you'll have the full link to the set of mockups that we have, because we've been quite detailed with these ones, since it is quite a large functionality that we are adding to Mahara. and you're very welcome to look all of them over, to read through the descriptions and let me know. And of course, you're already welcome to try it out yourself. If you happen to have a Mahara developer environment, you can already download the patches with the progress that we've made so far, because we are currently, or we have most of that functionality already in testing, and now go through our internal testing process, which will take a bit so that we cover off as many of the test cases as we can, and then share that with our client and also put it into Mahara Core, into Mahara 23.04. Now, the other big feature that we are working on is for one of our Canadian clients, and that is to change the submission process, because they are using a learning management system, which is not Moodle, so they don't have access to the Mahara Assignment Submission plugin, which does make a few things easier. But with them, we are relying solely on LTI, the Learning Tools Interoperability protocol. And we can't really integrate very closely with the learning management system, therefore need to find a way of making the processes simpler on the Mahara side. And so for quite a long time, we've been thinking about and wondering, well, what is the best way to submit a portfolio, make an archive of it, and could we still, do we do the archive at the start of the submission process? Do we do it at the end like we do now? Do we actually just never submit a portfolio and make a copy? And now through the work that university has done, and also the feedback that they've received by using LTI quite intensively, we've come to the conclusion that submitting a copy of a portfolio is the best way forward and allows us quite a bit of flexibility for the submissions of portfolios, as well as also submitting parts of a portfolio. And so what that means is that when you submit a portfolio, be that in a Mahara group or via LTI, you are actually never submitting that original portfolio, but you are making a copy so that you can continue editing the original portfolio if you wanted to, or later on when your submitted copy is being released and you need to make changes, then you can use that in order to continue working on your portfolio. And so that your screen is not overloaded, when you are on your portfolio's overview page, we just make sure that we can exclude submitted portfolios and only show those original portfolios or those that have come back being released and not being marked as submissions anymore. So those are our current big projects that the team is working on, besides also making some smaller changes and fixes and small features. And I find these really, really exciting because they push us forward through the work that our clients are allowing us to do and have a number of usability improvements, but also bring new features in, improve workflows, make things more streamlined, and therefore easier to use. And that's basically how you can get involved in Mahara yourself. You can commission features, or you can also commission bug fixes. That is very much appreciated as well, because that just helps things, makes things go faster into the code base. And you are very welcome to talk with your account manager in the EU to see what is possible, and then whether the work is being performed by the European team or by our team, that is to be seen depending on the availability of the developers. and we do work across different time zones, which can be very beneficial. And we'd just like to encourage everybody to think about what would you like to have changed, because sometimes it might just really be a quick or a small change that we can handle very easily for you, and you just have massive benefits and less support required from your instructional designers or learning designers, or students just don't have as many questions. But of course, you can also get involved in the Mahara community in a number of other ways. You could help with translations, or you could report bugs, or also provide feedback on how things are going in your organization, how you've seen the use of portfolios, what you have noticed, and provide us that specific feedback so that we in the Mahara core team have a better understanding of how the platform is being used these days and also what is being expected. So all of that is always wonderful to hear and to know what is going on in order to make Mahara better for everybody who is using it. Now, you might already seen that there's also one way for you to get involved, is not just on the technical side, of course, and thinking about features or thinking about workflows, but also sharing your stories. So at the end of September, we launched Create, Share, Engage, which is the podcast by the Mahara Project. Since then, we've had 5 episodes, and I was hesitating briefly because the 6th one will actually be released in a few hours. So please do make sure to subscribe in your podcast app, or go to the website podcast.mahara.org in order to listen to all of those episodes. They are all in English, and episodes are released every other week. And in the podcast, we are sharing portfolio stories from people around the world in order to showcase what is being done also at different institutions around portfolios, be that on the implementation level, be that methodologically, pedagogically, new ideas of what people are trying to do with portfolios. And while most of the guests are, of course, people using Mahara, I am also interviewing people who are not using Mahara, because there's lots and lots of great ideas in the community around portfolio use. We'll also be talking about non-portfolio topics, but topics that are adjacent to Mahara and portfolios. So in January, I'll be sharing an interview with our accessibility expert so that we can talk a bit more about web accessibility. And later in the year, I'll also talk with a few other people around general educational technology matters and things like that. So if you are interested and want to share your organization's story, please do feel free to send me an email, and then we can arrange for a catch-up that is then also recorded and made available freely to the world. If you're following the Mahara Project on social media, you will also have seen that we have an advent calendar. Again, the link is in the shared notes for you to click. I specifically left the 6th door closed for you so that you do not yet that you didn't already see it before I talked. And I'd really like to encourage you to check it out and maybe find some new ideas of what others have been doing in the community, but also to make sure that you enter our prize draws that we still have. There are still 8 to come. So 8 chances to win a variety of different prizes, mainly consulting prizes, so that you can win a free hour with Sam, for example, or with me, or a support package. So there's a bunch of opportunities for you to win, and we are certainly honoring time zones so that you don't have to worry about me closing the door to one of those prices at midnight New Zealand time. But no, we wait until the entire world has finished with the day to give you a bit more of a chance. Now, pretty much the last link to share, something that you might want to receive on a regular basis, is the monthly Catalyst newsletter that deals with all things portfolios. You can find the link also in the shared notes. And if you subscribe today, you will receive the first issue then tomorrow, because I publish that newsletter always on the first Wednesday of the month, New Zealand time. So it goes out about 8 p.m. your time tonight. And so I look forward to you receiving those, for you to sign up and also spread the word of portfolios and Mahara widely within your institutions. And I'd also look forward to hearing from you if you want to send feedback or your thoughts on Mahara directly. There are a lot of different channels available. Email, Mastodon or Fediverse in general, LinkedIn or Twitter. And I also put the Mahara details for Mastodon, LinkedIn and Twitter in onto this slide as well, and share the Mastodon details, because those are probably the ones that you might not already have in the shared notes. And that's pretty much it from me around roadmap, what is coming up in exciting new features in Mahara 23.04. And if you have any questions, then I think we still have about 2.5 minutes before you would be off to the next event.